One of the nozzle on the heat exchanger is shell inlet nozzle. As seen in this example, the shell inlet nozzle is positioned at the farthest distance from the fixed saddle. Therefore, the thermal expansion of the shell inlet nozzle will be relatively greater than the other nozzles. Piping design like this will resist the thermal expansion of the exchanger. Due to its own weight, the pipe will tend to expand towards the exchanger. However, the exchanger will tend to expand in the direction of the pipe rack due to the fixed saddle position. Ultimately, excessive loads at the connection point, the nozzle, between the pipe and the exchanger will result in high stresses, leading to excessive stress at the shell connection of the nozzle. To prevent the occurrence of the excessive stress, we will need to make some revisions to the pipe design. Three-dimensional changes on pipe routing will always help the pipe flexibility. So, as seen in the animation, the revision is to provide a downward turn to the pipe from the nozzle. This downward turn will give additional flexibility to the pipe. At the same time, the pipe will not create resistance against the expansion direction of the exchanger, so there will be minimum load. Here, to achieve a similar behavior between the pipe and the exchanger, you can relocate the trunnion under the elbow to align it with the height of the exchanger's saddle. This way, the axial moment that may occur on the nozzle is minimized. You can also implement such a solution at high temperatures. The thermal expansion of the exchanger due to high temperatures can be tolerated in this way. I would like to draw your attention specifically to the trunnion elevation in this example.